Shalom, shalom, shalom. First and foremost, I'd like to give all praises to the Most High Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Bruka Kodash. Then I'd like to send my double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, GMS, for having taught me this truth, which is the 100% truth, and also for ruling well. And peace and salutations to the hopeful elect spread around the four corners of the earth, to those who are laboring in the vine in these last days, and also to those who are sincerely seeking this truth. So I am doing this lesson because of just to give you people a short update of what's going on in Italy. And as you all know, Italy is in the phase of selecting a new prime minister, and it's almost definite that the new prime minister is Mario Draghi. Okay, so I was just taking a look at his name and checking a little bit of his biography, and I found some interesting thing I would like to share. So here in Italy, what has been going on lately is the prime minister that we have, who is Conte, actually is a sort of person. He doesn't have that much action, you know, but they actually put him there in that time period, you know, so as to let it seem like they have a prime minister that is not active, you know. So over some months now, let's say right from the time of the beginning of this pandemic, so what they've been doing is, you know, they've been trying to discredit this prime minister, you know. If they're actually the one who put these people in these positions to do such things, you know, we know that all these people, they're actually puppets in the hands of the so-called elites, you know. So they put him in that position to make it look like, you know, things are not moving. So now they've been coming with different blames, like we are behind with the vaccination plan, we're behind with this, our economy is behind, and all sort of, you know, stories to put in someone who is going to, you know, come up stronger, a little bit stronger with these draconian laws, you know. So this is actually what they've been planning, and, you know, they call it, you know, they try to condition the mind of the people into accepting that, oh, you know, things are slow, we need to go back to normal, we need someone who is going to come out more with, you know, someone who has more authority, you know, someone is going to, you know, put in that draconian law, you know. So I believe they actually got to this point and they found someone who is really ready for the job. So, well, I'd first of all like to share from the book of Job chapter 9 verse 24, which quotes, "The earth is given into the hands of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he?" Okay, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked. So as we know, those of us that we are in the truth, we know that this present kingdom is actually in the hands of the wicked, the sons of the so-called white man, that's the Caucasian race, the sons of Esau, you know. The earth is actually given into their hands now, and they are actually doing whatever they like with it. So they put in whoever they want to put, you know. So all these, you know, prime ministers and presidents and all these people, they're all just they're just puppets, you know. They're actually puppets, you know. They kept there for certain reason and certain times. So now let's go. This is the new prime minister. The soul to become prime minister, you know, that's, we just heard the president, you know, give a speech and he decided he has chosen him. So we don't know if they would confirm it, but I believe they will confirm this man. So, you know, his name is Mario Draghi. So now let's just take a little look at his biography. Mario Draghi, okay, born on the 3rd of September 1947, is an Italian economist and central banker who served as president of the European Central Bank. Okay, so we all know this history of this banks, these banking families. We know they have a strong history of, you know, impoverishing the whole earth and, you know, stealing the real currency, which is gold and silver, and you know, putting out this counterfeits and worthless currency out there, which are your euro and your dollar bills and whatever currency you use that's paper, you know. So between 2011 and 2019, before that, it was the inaugural chair of the Financial Stability Board from 2009 to 2011. I was also governor to the Bank of Italy from 2005 to 2011. So as you guys can see, this so-called man, Mario Draghi, which his surname sounds like dragon, which this is Italian. It means actually dragons. Draghi actually means dragons, okay? So you can see that it comes from, you know, he has a background of, you know, he's someone prominent, you know, he's a really good puppet who's been used usually and regularly. And there is a reason why they're putting this man in this position now. So let's just take a little more look, you know. After a lengthy career as an academic economist in Italy, Draghi also worked for the World Bank. So you can see he's involved in all this high, okay, in the 1980s. And was eventually appointed Director General of the Italian Treasury. He left public service in 2001 to join Goldman Sachs. Okay, so I am just keeping all this, you know, have been, you know, looking at this different, you know, highlighted, you know, names to get more information. And you can see that this man actually is really, really a high level, a high level citizen in this world, you know, this kingdom, you know, he's of a high level. And let's see, you know, this is what they just wrote here. I think they just added this today on February 2, 2021, in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic in Italy, Draghi was invited by Italian President Sergio Mattarella to form a new government following the resignation of Giuseppe Conte during the 2021 Italian government crisis. Okay, so this crisis was actually, you know, all a form up by these people. They actually came up with all this in order to put in this man, this Draghi in power. And let's see. Mario Draghi was born in Rome, 1946. He rose up in a upper class family. So if you go through that upper class family, you can see upper class family in modern society is the social class composed of people who hold the highest social status, usually are the wealthiest member of the class society and wield the greatest political power. I'm not going to go into much of that, but you can just see that this guy actually comes from one of the wealthiest members of the family and a huge political power, okay? So let's go back to what we're reading. You see, so he's from a upper class family. His father, Carlo, joined the Bank of Italy, okay? Then in 1922, later instituted the industrial reconstruction, okay? And I can just tell you that this is just like a fraction of the Rothschild family, the Italian Rothschild, you know, this is a fraction of their family. And in the end, Banca Nazionale del Lavoro, because these are huge institutes that holds Italy as a country, you know. So while his mother, Giuda Mancini, was a pharmacist, so as you can see, this dude's mother was a pharmacist, while the father was a very high, you know, class, you know, this, you know, financist, let's say, a branch of the family of the Rockefellers. And we know that pharmacists are sorcerers, okay? He is the first of the three children. Then let's see, there is a point I actually saw here. Okay, this is the point. Draghi studied at the Massimiliano Institute, a Jesuit school in Rome. Okay, Jesuits. Are you guys familiar about this Jesuit? Now let's touch this Jesuit. And you can see the Society of Jesuits is a religious order of the Catholic Church headquartered in Rome. It was founded by Ignatius of Loyola and six companions with the approval of Pope Paul III in 1540. Okay, the members are called Jesuits. The society is engaged in evangelization and apostolic ministry in 112 nations. Jesuit work in education, research, and cultural pursuits. Jesuit also give retreat, minister in hospital parishes, sponsor direct social ministry, and promote ecumenical dialogues. Well, if you go into you know, the deep history of this Jesuit, you know, it's nothing but a demonic, you know, sect, you know. So this is their logo, which shows you they worship the sun god, you can see. And these are the three nails that they used in crucifying Yahweh Shai, you know. So now let me just show you something else. Now if you come here and you put in the name of the guy that formed the Illuminati, which is Adam Weishaupt. Okay, no. Not, sorry. There we go. This that you see here is the portrait of Adam Weishaupt. Okay, he actually is the founder of the Illuminati. You know, John Adam Weishaupt, 6th February, was a German philosopher, professor of civil law, and later canon law, and founder of the Illuminati, a secret society. And as you know, the Illuminati, these people, they actually, it's a secret society of the most prominent people, the wealthiest people of the society, you know. It's just a small fraction of what they used to operate, you know. So now let me, the reason why I'm showing you this is because I want to show you a little of this Adam Weishaupt's history, you know. So anyway, let's read from here. Adam Weishaupt was born in 6 April 1748 in Ingolstadt in the Electorate of Bavaria. Weishaupt's father, George Weishaupt, died. Okay, anyway, this is what I wanted to show you. Okay, Weishaupt began his formal education at age 7 at a Jesuit school. So if you get to look at all these people, these great so-called great men of this kingdom of the wicked, you know, they are actually members of the Jesuits, you know. So there is still a lot more, you know, we can get from all this information. But what I just wanted to show you about this man, this Draghi, you know, many Italians are actually like, oh, where did this man come out from, you know? They kind of surprised all of a sudden he just came from nowhere. It doesn't really, I don't think he even has he has a political party or anything. He just came out from, you know, from the box. They just brought him out of the box. And this man is going to be the next prime minister. So you can see this man, he also went to the school of the Jesuits, you see. And he is from the upper class, you know, the banking classes and the pharmaceutical classes. And you see, you know, these people, they know actually what they're doing. And the reason why, okay, I'm doing this video is because this man now is going to bring all hell in Italy. He's going to, you know, he's going to put in all those, you know, harsh draconian law. You know, it just sounds like his name. Okay, so his job actually his job is to how should I, I'm looking for the right word. His job is to say yes and put a go ahead to these draconian laws, in which the first is going to make sure that everyone gets, you know, the job. If not, you lose your job, you know. As I said, in my workplace, where in the plantation where I work, they already sent us letters, you know, telling us about these jobs, you know. So this man is going to be the one to give power to all these laws. And one of his major duties is that of also introducing the digital currency and making Italy a so-called smart country, okay. So, well, I just wanted to share this few infos that I looked out from this man, You know, but always remember, you know, as the scripture says here, the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. It covereth the face of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? You know, this man is the so-called white man who is this the seed of Esau. Okay. Having said this, I hope someone is edified today. And I would like to give all praises to the Most High Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rukah Kudash. And I'd like to send my double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, GMS, for having taught me this truth, which is the 100% truth. And peace and salutations to the hopeful elect spread around the four corners of the earth. On to the next one. Shalom.